fly them quite far. We cruise at speeds around Mach 0.7 or above. Sometimes, as a joke, air traffic controllers do ask, what type of aircraft is that propeller aircraft that is flying so high and with such a high speed? But yes, it's true, it is happening. Operating at very high altitudes, and you can see the payload versus range performance that you can achieve with the F110 here centered around Dubai. Now, what does that mean if we talk about 30 tons, 20 tons? Well, let's take a look at some examples. Sorry. You can take a load of 37 tons, like a heavy excavator, plus some personnel and pallets, and you can move it from here to Dubai into, for example, the Indian subcontinent. You take 20 tons, which is a typical payload of medium airlifters. Straight out of Dubai, you can cover the whole of Europe, you can go into Southeast Asia, and most parts of Africa. And if you just do one technical stop to refuel, you can reach Australia, you can reach North America, you can even reach into South America. Now, this is really game-changing in terms of payload and reach capability that you can achieve with an aircraft like this. And this is exactly what our air forces are doing nowadays, and they are seeing this capability being put into use and delivering the effects that they are planning with. Now, one of the key characteristics of the aircraft, and this has been also one of the main design parameters, is the ability of the aircraft to operate from short and unpaved airstrips. As an example, the F110, carrying a load of 25 tons, can fly over 2,200 nautical miles, can land on a grass and soft airstrip with a low CBR, deliver that load, and still has enough fuel to take off again and fly another 500 nautical miles and recover at another airbase. That means for our air forces, for example, operating out of Europe, they can deliver this type of loads into many airstrips in Africa, and they're doing that. They can unload, take off again, and recover at the same location in Africa. And the experience that our users have had up to now using the aircraft in environments like this is very positive. There are hardly any damages on the aircraft. And also, what is very important is that the aircraft does not damage the runway. Because when you land on runways like this, it's very important that you don't land and then the airstrip is damaged, so you cannot take off, or other aircraft cannot land. And why is this so? Because we have a very, very sturdy landing gear, three independent struts on each side, double wheels everywhere. You will see it on the aircraft later on. It evenly distributes the load on the surface, and we can go onto softer terrain than the C-130 can, although we are much larger than the C-130. So really, really extremely well-performing in this role.